From the station that's on your side, this is Channel 7 News Good Morning Arkansas.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Thursday, July 18th edition of Good Morning Arkansas. I'm Kayla Lafferty.
Good to have everybody here. I'm Melinda Mayo, and coming up on today's show, we've got the doctor in, Dr. Morgan Sauer with Baptist Health, back in studio this morning. And today we're talking about some new research that has found some commonly prescribed drugs are possibly tied to nearly 50% higher dementia risk in older adults. So we're going to talk to him about this study, what it means for those folks who perhaps have dementia or they want to, you know, prevent that. So he'll talk about some of the new findings they have.
Yeah, and that's a really important study that a lot of us need to be looking out for. Yeah.
Welcome back to Good Morning Arkansas. We are always happy to have Dr. Morgan Sauer in with Baptist Health. Back in the studio this morning, we're going to talk about some new research that kind of has us looking at some commonly prescribed drugs and what that might mean for the dementia risk, especially in older adults. And I know you work with seniors a lot.
I do.
Yes,
I'm love a geriatrician.
That. Yes, very good. Well, let's talk about this new research. It was something that you guys had kind of looked at before, certain drugs affecting dementia.
There's a certain class of drugs called anticholinergic medications. And these medications actually work opposite of the drugs that we use to treat dementia right now.
Oh, okay.
There's evidence that has been pointing toward this, and this study is really a big red flag saying not only can this cause some problems, it may increase your risk for Alzheimer's if you use it before you go into seniorhood or during seniorhood.
Okay, so first of all, what are these drugs usually used for? What are they prescribed for?
Some of them are antidepressants, some of which are used commonly for sleep, some anti-seizure medications, and very frequently bladder medications to try and help people when their bladders are overactive. Mm-hmm. Some of the generic ones of these are certainly implicated in this.
Okay, so how did they conduct this study? How many did they have?
And they had tens of thousands of people in this study, and they were age 55 and older. So it's pre-seniorhood,
right?
Kind of what I call the preschool for geriatrics. And they looked, and if you took one of these medications for 3 or more years within a 10-year period, not every single day for 3 years, but in a 10-year period, mm-hmm. it actually increased your risk for Alzheimer's by 50%.
Wow, that's a lot.
Actually, by these numbers, we could possibly attribute 10% of Alzheimer's cases to use of these medications if the continuing studies bear out. What you need to see is if you stop these, do you get reversal?
Yeah, and I guess you've got to look, did they take it every day? Those kinds of questions too when you're looking at the results, really for any study, right?
Sure, because this was used on how much was filled at the pharmacy, but we also know a lot of people get stuff filled at the pharmacy and mm-hmm. never bothered to take it.
Exactly.
So that's important to know too.
Yeah, but a 50% jump possible in the risk, I mean, what do you think about that?
Again, this is a huge study, but it's showing all physicians these drug classes are a major problem. We have got to be careful in our senior citizens. We know they affect memory. We know they affect cognition in the short term, but also now there's long-term consequences. So think about seniors when they're trying to drive, when they're trying to even do things around the house like turning the stove on and off and forgetting.
Right.
So these drugs are really, really need to be looked at and understand the risks and benefits.
For you to say these work opposite of what we're trying to give them for dementia, that's mm-hmm. something to really pay attention to. So what can we do if you're on one of these drugs? First of all, go to your doctor, I'm sure, and have a talk.
You do need to have a talk because some of these drugs are used for seizures. Some of these drugs are used for depression. And so it's important to talk to your doctor. Okay, what are my risks? What are my benefits? What are my alternatives? What else can I do? Certain other medications, they're actually lifestyle changes that we can do. And boy, I know most people don't like doing lifestyle changes. Mm-hmm. It's easier to take that pill.
Right.
But there are things we can do, like for depression, getting involved in exercise, making sure that you're eating right, even getting into therapy, which is just as effective as medications are. And for the bladder, there's certainly things that can be done, physical therapy modalities that can be used to help the bladder, and certain types of lifestyle changes. If you have seizures, obviously don't stop your medicine cold turkey. You can change over to another medication that's going to be a lot safer.
Okay, those lifestyle changes can many times do away with your prescriptions, and that's the case in many different health issues, isn't it?
We can treat ourselves with exercise and food for a lot of the common conditions we see, and even the biggest killers in the U.S.
Okay, so a good conversation to start with your doctor and say, hey, you know, I'm 60, I'm worried about, you know, memory loss and dementia, and I'm on this drug. So what would you suggest? Where do you think this is going to go in the future as far as this study goes?
I think the next steps are looking at what happens if you stop these medications. Mm-hmm. So what if you only use them cumulatively for a year and you stop them? What does that do to your risk? Also, what are reversible factors that we can put into this? And I think this also helps point toward mechanisms of action. You know, we don't really truly know what causes Alzheimer's. We're still trying to figure that out. And this could really point and say, you know, you need to look over here. We've been looking at the, as I call it, the plaque theory for the past 25 years, and the plaque theory is not really holding up. Mm-hmm. None of the drugs that attack plaques are doing a lot. And so looking at other alternatives like insulin resistance in the cells, I call it diabetes type 3, diabetes of the brain. Right. And so there are other things that we need to look at more and kind of expand our focused point of view.
Yeah, we're seeing it so much in our seniors, and you know, it's something that needs to be studied. What about, I know you just work with a lot of people who say, I'm starting to get forgetful. Is that dementia or is that just kind of getting older? How do you answer that?
The biggest thing is there are a lot of things that affect memory and affect behavior. And so depression can look just like Alzheimer's, and you can't tell the difference until you actually try doing something for it. Thyroid disorders, B12 deficiency, folic acid deficiency. There are a lot of things that can affect memory. And so if people are worried about their memory, adopting a healthy lifestyle of eating clean, getting aerobic exercise, especially walking, which has been shown to help increase blood flow to certain parts of the brain where Alzheimer's starts, and talking to your doctor about getting a good comprehensive workup on the front side, and then you can compare yourself over time. But those lifestyle choices are huge, and your physicians can help with that.
Absolutely. And if you're on one of these drugs or one of your family members is, and you want to, you know, talk about the study, they can always give you guys a call, right?
We're happy to help.
Yeah, a lot of people specializing in senior adults, just like Dr. Sauer. So let's put up the information, of course, for Baptist Health, and this is really for any medical issues that you have. You can talk to them, and they can certainly set you up with a doctor that specializes in what you need. And there's the number 1-888-BABDIST, toll free as well, if you're outside the Little Rock area too. Thank you, Dr. Sauer. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
We'll be waiting to hear on more studies to come, right?
We look forward to it.
Thank you.